Well, 6 years ago when I was playing in Japan, in Osaka, with Vernon Reid, the guitar player, we had the idea that we should do this because I played with Lifetime a long time ago, and Tony Williams was a very good friend, very close friend, and an inspiration musically to me and to a lot of other people, including Vernon and Cindy and John. So it was really our idea, but then Vernon finally said, let's do it, and I said, yeah. And we came up with those musicians because they are the perfect ones to play in this band. It's very exhilarating, uplifting, and very moving as well, because it brings back the memories of playing with Lifetime. So it's a very positive experience. And I think in this time in the world, it's nice to have that kind of idealism that we had in those days to play. Right, well, Tony, I first met Tony when I first heard Tony's playing in on a record called Out to Lunch, Eric Dolphy record. And Tony was very young when he played that, probably only 17, 18, something like that. Tony joined Miles Davis when he was 17. That's what an amazing drummer he was, a prodigy. But then he took the music beyond just the drumming. He started to write music, and people like Gil Evans did arrangements of his compositions, and it was going in that direction. And of course, when I joined, I'm also a composer, so we were just working together. And Tony's a very important person in music generally, and he unfortunately died before he was able to do all the things he should have been able to do. Well, I think he was a really great composer. I think potentially, but he was just starting to write in the direction, you know, that he would have been going in. He was writing string quartets, and he was going in a whole different direction as a composer. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to finish his work. But I love his compositions. You know, they're very free because some of them are very structured and some are very free, so it gives you a lot of space to be yourself.
Why don't you say what you mean? 'Cause you didn't mean what you said. Maybe you're aware there are people who are sharing. Yeah, sharing all their fears. You know, everything is said in the bed, and it shouldn't change just 'cause you're wet. That's right. That's right. You heard me. Don't be afraid to stand up when it counts. Why can't you give in just 'cause it's nice? It's all in fun, don't you know? Yeah, it can be fun, don't you know? It's having fun that you grow. Thank you. said, why don't you say what you mean? Because I didn't understand what you said. Maybe aware that there are people who are sharing. Yeah, sharing. All their fears. You know, everything is said in the bed. It shouldn't change just cause you're wet. That's right, you heard me. Don't be afraid to stand up when it counts. Why can't you give in? Just cause it's nice. It's all fun, don't you know? Yeah, it can be fun, don't you know? It's having fun. That you grow. Oh, 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 oh.
Well, I played with the best drummers in the world, Ginger Baker, Billy Cobham, Simon Phillips. Better not, I can't think of everybody, but I think my favorite of all is Tony, always was. There was something about his playing, it was in the real tradition of jazz. He was the continuation of the jazz music, going back to probably Baby Dodds in New Orleans and so on. So for me, it was a great honor initially to join Lifetime. That was a great honor, which was after Cream. And it's also an honor for me to play with these guys too. Oh, she's an amazing drummer. She has everything going for her, and also she has studied Tony Williams really like he's the master and she's the student. But she's really taken it to another level. That's the important thing with this band. Although it's a tribute to Tony and to the music of Lifetime, we are still ourselves. So I think she's fantastic. Yeah. Well, we're talking about it. We want to play as much as we can. Obviously, we all have our own separate projects, but we want to play in some jazz festivals and some different places all over the world. So if you've got any offers... But there are certain criteria, certain limits and rules. It's not just playing anything, you know. It's sort of like recomposition, I would call it, rather than improvisation. You take the piece and you rewrite it. But it's very free. But then it you have to be very careful what you play. You can't just play anything, otherwise it's just it's meaningless. It's like a conversation. That's what we're having on stage. We're talking to each other all the time and listening to each other too. Oh, I just walk around a lot. That's all I do. It's very difficult, very interesting to go to a new place to try and get a feeling of the country. Whatever country I go to, I just walk around and get lost.